About 15 miles south of downtown Cleveland lies Wolf Creek. The creek is a natural waterway that's been integrated into the region's 380 square mile sewer system. Its job is to help carry away rainwater that flows down the region's storm drain.
Upstream, this is actually just a normal creek. It's opened, and on the sides of the bank, trees just from erosion will fall in. We get hit by some massive storms up here, and they flush a lot of junk and trash into the system, so we know after a storm, we could be potentially in for a very long day.
A recent rainfall has washed a large amount of debris into the creek. It's trapped by these gates and needs to be removed so the creek doesn't overflow.
Hey, one of you guys want to just hook these up for me? I'm gonna, as soon as I boom over here, whichever ones that what you want to pull out to get into.
Probably this one?
For the back tube, yeah.
You want to do just, are you taking one or two off?
Yeah, let's do these two right here.
Okay.
Here. I'm gonna boom over here.
The maintenance crew's cleanup operation starts with Todd.
I'm a HEFTO, which is a heavy equipment field tech operator. I operate the cranes and heavy equipment that we have here at the sewer district. Whenever something comes up, I'm ready. I'm ready to do it. As long as it doesn't have to do with computers, I'm good.
Today, Todd will be operating the articulating crane, also called a knuckle boom. Its unique and compact design makes it highly mobile, which is good for a crew like Todd's that's always on the move.
The hatches, they're a little deceiving. They look like you're like, oh, well, you need a crane to lift those, but really, they're probably a couple hundred pounds a piece. They're all stainless steel grating. We use this to pull those, and that gives us a better access.
With the grates out of the way, the team can deploy their vacuum truck to suck up the first layer of smaller debris.
I'm taking it up.
I'm not mentally prepared for this today.
But even the truck's supercharged suction power has its limits.
All right, guys. Hey, we're gonna have to cut this tree up. We got some larger limbs down here. It's wedged in. We had some high winds, a lot of rain and some storms last night. And upstream, this is actually just a normal creek. It's opened, and on the sides of the bank, trees just from erosion will fall in. And every once in a while, we get a big enough storm, enough water pushes those trees and those limbs and all that debris down. And this is the last stop before it heads upstream or downstream. That's one of the main functions of our structure here, is to catch that debris. We check this to make sure everything's in order, basically. Check the debris level. We got here today, and a pretty common feature that we find in here, a lot of debris, rags, street debris, bottles and stuff. We'll clean the chamber out and remove the debris as well. This is important because this is a natural culverted creek that this structure is built on. And the structure's here to take the initial flow of that heavy rain when it starts. There's two gate structures in here that'll take some of the quote-unquote dirty water into the tunnel. And then once the dirty water is relieved and flushed, then the clean water will go back to the creek. So that's why this structure's here, and we're gonna remove that debris. The tree limbs and the stumps were actually wedged underneath the bar rack that's down there that goes towards the environment. And that happens, the water rushes through there, it's rushing all that stuff through there, and it gets wedged in between the rack. So we just have to remove that and make sure that the rack and everything's not bent up. We're gonna have to cut this up, it's wedged up.
Okay.
You can cut the small stuff up, bundle it up. We're gonna have to do that before we back.
All right, I'll get suited up and then I'll come down.
Lumberjack status, let's go.
A slippery coating of leaves and mud beneath the surface makes for unsure footing, which is a dangerous scenario when 24-inch chainsaws are involved.
We want everybody to leave with their hands, their fingers, their feet. We really have to make sure that that happens. We have to pay attention not only for ourselves, but for one another.
Equipment operator Todd is tearing it up on the banks of Cleveland's Wolf Creek. breaking down a fallen tree so that the crew can clean out this catch basin and avoid a major flood to the southeast region of the city.
All right, I'm gonna start the truck up.
With the branches now out of the way, the vacuum truck can suck up the debris that's blocking the creek. The truck's tank holds up to 1,200 gallons, but that'll fill up too quickly if they take on too much water. So the team needs to attack the job with precision.
So I'm just poking a little hole in the bar rack here so the water can flow out so we can eliminate some of this water. It'll show us what we got underneath there in terms of grit and debris. And then so we're not sucking up mostly water. We just want to suck up the debris. Drop the hose.
All right, coming down.
Give it to me. Give it to me.
And tip coming down.
All right, another set of hands. As long as you're not feet, because Nate couldn't handle it. Cody, if you see any big branches and crap, you know, just stack them up.
The catch basin's job is to literally catch any and all debris that comes its way, which means the crew has found some pretty wild things down there.
Oh, gosh, there's all kinds of things that we clean out regularly. A lot of it is unidentifiable. Wigs, used condoms, we see a lot of tampon applicators, sewer missiles, we call those. You first start, though, you're like, oh, okay, that's a little gross.
Everything looks pretty good.
Yep. Good.
Coming down.
I think we had found two items in the same place. It was like a tractor trailer tire and rim in there, along with a car fender.
I was back at one time, sucked up a dead cat. Didn't know it till we went and dumped the truck and a skinless cat dropped out the back.
But whether the junk in this trap is weird, scary, or just plain gross, it's all gotta go.
Todd, there's like a can right by your foot. Up this way a little bit, towards me. See it? Get crap out of there, Captain Planet.
And after 10 hours of hard work, the basin is free and clear of debris, and the crew packs up the fresh sewer lumber to haul it out.
Yeah, we're on top, if we can get them on top. Come on, you youngsters. Nice and tight.
Fastest breakdown I've ever done in a while.
This is our goal, you know, nice and clear. We're ready for the next storm now.
In South Cleveland, a section of Wolf Creek is culverted, which means a street runs over the top of it.
So this is going under Henry Street, which is right above us. It's going under parking lots, going under houses.
Now that the creek has been cleared of debris, crew member Josh heads into the culvert to make sure the water is flowing freely.
We'll come down here just a little bit just to check, just to give a good glance at the integrity of the culvert. Kind of see what's coming down the chamber, so to speak. If there's any large pieces of debris. Here's another little storm outlet, comes into the culvert. And we just come around the corner a little bit here. And we can just kind of look. So everything looks like in good shape. That wraps up this, ready to go.